Hello, welcome to another module in this massive open online course. So let us consider another digital modulation scheme, in fact, which is a very general and powerful digital modulation scheme, which is one of the most commonly used digital modulation scheme, which is used in all the modern wireless communication standards such as 3G, 4G and also potentially in the future in 5G wireless communication standards. All right, this is known as QAM or quadrature amplitude modulation, and to some extent is a generalization of all the schemes that we have seen before, that is your BPSK, amplitude shift keying, PAM also, so QAM is a general version of all these things. Okay, so let us start looking at quadrature quadrature. So let us start looking at quadrature amplitude modulation, or this is basically this is also known as QAM, and to be a bit more precise, this is known as Emery QAM, Emery quadrature amplitude modulation. Basically, this implies that there are M symbols, as we have seen Emery PAM, in Emery QAM there are M symbols. Okay. Now, similar to quadrature phase shift keying, as I said, this is a generalization of QPSK. Similar to quadrature phase shift keying, similar to quadrature phase shift keying, there are two pulses P1 and P2. P2T, which are orthonormal, okay, and we have XT equals A1 times P1T plus A2 times P2T. Okay. So, and now A1, in QPSK each A1, A2 are two BPSK symbols, all right, A1, A2 element of plus or belongs to either plus or minus pi. Here A1 and A2 can be two separate PAM symbols, that is the whole idea. There can be two separate, there can be two separate PAM symbols. So, A1 and A2 are drawn from a PAN constellation independently, okay, independent symbols drawn from a PAM constellation, okay. These are independent symbols from a PAM constellation. Okay, so A1, so we have pulse P1T on which we are transmitting symbol A1, pulse P2T on which we are transmitting symbol A2, both A1 and A2 are individual PAM symbols. Now, in quadrature phase shift keying QPSK, A1 and A2 are individual BPSK, binary phase shift keying, that is A1 is plus or minus A, A2 is plus or minus A. Here we are generalizing this concept. So, A1 can belong to a PAM pulse amplitude modulation, A2 can belong to PAM, and A1 and A2 are independent symbols. So, we are transmitting two PAM symbols per every waveform XT, okay, two PAM symbols for every waveform XT. Okay. Now, as we have seen in QPSK, our P1T, this is similar to QPSK, that is unit energy pulses. square root of 2 over t cosine 2 pi f c t plus p 2 t a square root of 2 over t sine 2 pi f c t zero less than equal to t less than equal to t, and the t is the duration of the symbol contains an integer number of cycles that is the same. P 1, P 2, T are unit energy, that is unit energy orthogonal pulses, that is a set of orthonormal pulses. This is similar to, in fact, identical, in fact, not even similar, this is simply identical, okay. That is, these are in quadrature, okay, to QPSK EP equals 1. Remember, this is your pulse energy. The pulse energy normalized to 1, and the basis P 1, P 2 t are in quadrature. P 1 t P 2 t are in quadrature, because remember sin 2 pi f c t plus pi by 2 root 2 over t sin 2 pi f c t plus pi by 2 equals root 2 over t cosine 2 pi f c t. So, differ by, what does it mean to say they are in quadrature? We have seen this before, pulses p 1 t p 2 t differ in phase by pi by 2. Differ in P1T, P2T differ in phase by pi by 2. Okay? So, the pulses are in quadrature. Okay? And the phase difference between these pulses is pi by 2, implies they are in quadrature. Okay? Now, let the total number of symbols in the QAM be m. So, we are saying this is an Emery QAM, total number of symbols. So, the total number of symbols, in fact, the total number of symbols in this constellation is equal to m. That is why it is known as, we have said that, that is the reason it is known as Emery QAM. Emery QAM means total number of symbols in the QAM constellation is m, okay, which means each, now this implies that each, now this is something that you have to understand, each a 1 a 2 is drawn from a PAM with square root of m. This is a key observation. So, each a 1 and a 2 is drawn from a PAM, that is PAM constellation, PAM symbol set with square root of m symbols. The reason being that a 1 belongs to a PAM constellation with square root of m symbols, that is a 1 can be chosen in square root of m ways. A 2 belongs to a PAM constellation with square root of m symbols, a 2 can be chosen in square root of m ways. So, the total QAM symbol can be chosen in square root of m into square root of m, that is m ways. Okay? So, the total number of symbols in the QAM then becomes square root of m into square root of m. This is similar to QPSK. For instance, a 1 is in QPSK, a 1 is chosen from plus or minus a, that is a set containing 2 symbols, BPSK. A 2 is chosen from a BPSK, set containing 2. So, the total number of symbols, constellation points in QPSK is 2 into 2, that is 4. Similarly, in Emery QAM, we are choosing a 1 and a 2 from PAM constellation with square root of m symbols. okay. So therefore, what happens is total number of symbols in QAM this is equal to square root of m into square root of m, which is basically simply equal to m. Okay. Now, similar to what we have described about PAM, except now we are using square root of Emery PAM, not Emery PAM. Note, we are now using, so everything remains the same except Emery PAM becomes square root. So Emery QAM can be thought of as comprised as being formed. So Emery QAM can be thought of as being formed from two independent square root of Emery PAM constellations. All right, so our PAM is going to be now a square root of Emery PAM. That is, each A1, A2 belongs to a square root of Emery PAM. That is the interesting aspect. Okay, so A1 comma A2 belong to a square root of Emery PAM, which means that A1 equals plus or minus 2i plus 1. 0 less than or equal to I. Remember, in Emery PAM we have 0 less than I less than or equal to m by 2 minus 1. This will be equal to square root. So naturally I have to replace m by square root of m. So this will be square root of m by 2 minus 1. So naturally, since we are considering 0 less than or equal to I less than or equal to square root of m over 2, this naturally means that remember, naturally means you cannot choose any value of m. Square root of m over 2 must be an integer. Naturally means that square root of m over 2 must be an integer. For example, we have 64 QAM that is m equal to 64, square root of m equal to 8, square root of m by 2 equal to 4, which is an integer. Okay. So, each PAM consists of 8 symbols. Each constituent PAM comprises of 8 symbols in 64 QAM, and naturally total number total number of bits per symbol in this QAM, 64 QAM, total number of bits per symbol equals log to the base 2 m, that is log to the base 2 64. This is basically log 2 to the base, log m to the base 2, which is basically 6. And you can see this corresponds to 3 bits per each PAM, which is 8 symbols. Log 8 to the base 2 is 3. So, 3 bits per each constituent PAM. So, the in phase component PAM, that is along P1T, carries 3 bits. PAM along the quadrature sin 2 pi fct pulse, square root of 2 over t sin 2 pi fct, carries 3 bits. Total number of bits is 6 bits per symbol in the 64 QAM. Okay. So, that is the point that we are trying to make. Okay. Now, similarly, let us complete this discussion over here. A2 is also plus or minus now 2j plus 1. Okay. A, where A is, remember, A is again the same, 0 less than or equal to square root of m by 2. Now, A is similar to before, where 2A is separation, is the separation or distance between levels. Separation between levels of the PAM, successive levels of the PAM is 2A. So, A1 is plus or minus 2i plus 1A, A2 is plus or minus 2j plus 1A, and both I and j lie between 0 and square root of m over 2 minus 1. Okay, so that is the point. Now, further, if average symbol, now let us find again the value of A. Remember, we have to keep the average symbol energy constant. So, let us say average symbol energy is ES for the Emery quorum. All right. Now, what is the corresponding value of A? Okay. Now, let us say average symbol energy equal to ES, which implies average energy. Now, there are two quorums. So, each shares half of the energy. So, average energy per A1 equals ES by 2. Average energy per A2 equals ES by 2. So, we say each quorum, each constituent PAM has half the symbol energy, that is ES by 2. Okay. Now, again going back to our PAM, now remember we have Emery PAM or square root of Emery PAM which means, and difference between levels is 2A, distance between levels is 2A. Which means average energy equals, well, A square by 3 times square root of m square minus 1. Now, remember, when we had Emery PAM, the energy was A square over 3 times m square minus 1. However, here we have a square root of Emery PAM. Therefore, the average energy per PAM is A square, for each constituent PAM is A square over 3 times square root of m square minus 1, square root of m whole square, square root of m square minus 1, which is basically m minus 1. Okay, and this should be equal to the average energy per PAM, which is ES over 2. So, we have ES over 2. So, this is a key step. Average energy per constituent PAM is ES over 2, and each PAM is only a square root of M PAM. So, therefore, we have this equation. Now, if you look at, if you do not remember this derivation, you can look at the derivation we have done for the Emery PAM. There we had ES equal to square root, ES is equal to A square over 3 times m square minus 1. Here we have ES over 2 equals A square by 3 into square root of m square minus 1, which basically implies ES is equal to, well, this basically implies, or the other way around rather, AS, or rather A is equal to 3 ES by 2 m minus 1, and this is an important element. So, the amplitude A, or the distance 2A, is such that A for each square root of Emery PAM, constituent square root of Emery PAM is chosen as 3 ES by 2 m minus 1. So, this ensures, remember what is the constraint here, ensures average energy ES for average energy ES for MRE for the MRE core. Okay. So, all right. So, what we have done here is basically we have introduced a different modulation, which is generalized version of PAM. In fact, for that matter, generalization of several schemes, BPSK, QPSK is generalization of BPSK, PAM is a generalization of BPSK, and QAM basically is a generalization of all these such modulation schemes. So, it contains a combination of two PAMs. There are two constituent PAM constellation, pulse amplitude modulation constitution, each of containing square root of m symbols. Therefore, the QAM is MRE, all right. So, MRE QAM is formed from two constituent square root MRE PAMs, each transmitted on one is transmitted on the cosine 2 pi FCT component, other is transmitted on the sine 2 pi FCT pulse. Both of the pulses are in quadrature. So, it is quadrature amplitude modulation, all right. Previously, our pulse amplitude modulation, now we are using two pulses which are in quadrature. So, it is quadrature amplitude modulation. Each constituent PAM is square root of m symbols, okay. And what we have derived is basically to ensure each constituent PAM has average symbol energy ES by 2, that ensures energy ES for the MRE QAM, and then we have derived a relation for the constant A, all right, correspond to each constituent square root MRE PAM such that the average symbol energy is ES for the overall QAM constellation. Okay. So, we will stop here, and in the next module, we will look at what is appropriate receiver, okay, the processing at the receiver and the resulting bit error rate, symbol error rate, and also this overall symbol error rate for the QAM constellation. Okay. Thank you very much.